Milton led the Knights for nearly three seasons until a devastating knee injury sidelined him in 2018. Remember, you can get breaking news around the clock on clickorlando.com and the new 6 app.
WDYC, Altamont Springs. WYGC, High Springs.
A JVC broadcasting station.
660 AM, 105.5 FM.
Florida Man Radio.
Florida Man Radio. The views and opinions on this program are not necessarily those of this station, JVC Broadcasting, management, or its sponsors. You have Power Radio with attorney Justin Clark on Florida Man Radio.
Do you swear to tell the truth? The whole truth? And nothing but the truth?
You want answers? You want answers!
I want the truth!
You can't handle the truth!
And welcome to Monday Morning. I am your host, Justin Clark, protecting you from the hypocrisy of America together. We will bully the bullies. Today on the program, I got my three holiday parties in a row out of the way. It's smooth sailing from here the rest of the year. Eight shows left for us this year. And then the 2020 of hell will be behind us. Also, the first virus vaccine has just been administered in New York City. Of course, during an Andrew Cuomo press conference. And plenty more to get to. Housekeeping before we begin. I'll be taking your calls and text messages. 321-339-1055. Download the Florida Man Radio app and listen to us right there around the globe. If you'd like to watch this show, we're at You Have Power Radio on Facebook, Twitch, YouTube. Two TV shows this weekend and every weekend, Saturday, 12:30 p.m. over on our news partner, News 6. It is You Have Real Estate. And then Sunday morning, 10 a.m. on TV 27. It is Behind the Law, but a great show for you this morning on the radio. But first, the team to my right, her hair is down and curly. Black tight pants with her new JVC Broadcasting sweatshirt. It is the beautiful Brianna. Hello, Brianna.
Hello, Justin.
Directly in front of me, a gray pressed Nike t-shirt. It is Lurch. Greetings.
Greetings.
321-339-1055.
And now it's time for the opening statement. This should be interesting.
Probably the most ill-timed three holiday parties in a row one could possibly have for me. Starting Thursday with the JVC event. You heard Bubba the Love Sponge talking about it earlier today. He was focusing more on chest, if you know what I'm saying, than the actual party itself. But it started Thursday, the day Pilar had surgery, which is just horrible timing for me. And then Friday, the law firm party. And then Saturday, we topped it all off with all the businesses together party up in Lake Mary. Brianna, first of all, you did a great job putting the party together. Thank you. Mm-hmm. We had quite a turnout. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Now, my biggest fear is someone's going to come down with the virus and say it was a super spreader event or something. But that's why we had a mask contest, Brianna.
Yeah.
We had a best mask, got $100. In fact, a lawyer from the law firm won the $100, I believe.
Yeah. Yeah, you did.
Isn't that right?
It's true.
So if indeed someone's going to get angry with me, I'm like, look, we were promoting a wearing of masks. Were we not?
Sure.
Exactly, we were. Without question, we were. Now, yeah. Lurch, you did show up. Thank you.
I did.
You came for a little bit. The only other person from the radio station, I believe, was Scott.
Yep, Scott was there.
Where was everybody?
Not sure.
You would think at least one person would have shown up from here. Not one. It was just the three of us. Oh, everyone is still tired from their own parties.
They could have been. I mean, this holiday party season, like everyone that was there, most of the people that were there were either that came from a party or heading to another party.
Oh. A lot of people did just kind of come by briefly and then leave because they had like three other parties to hit.
Yeah. And most of the way parties are set up, they're normally in one general area, but ours is like out in Heathrow. So unless you literally had another party to go to out in Heathrow, you know, we were a stopping place. I think we were a good one, though.
Oh, yeah. Probably 150 people there. It was a very good turnout, I would say.
I believe so.
Over the course of several hours. So. Yeah. It was good. Got a lot of rest yesterday.
Did you?
Yeah. I mean, three parties in a row. Absolutely. I just wanted to chill yesterday, finally. And I did just that.
That's It's good. Are you still on the beanbag? Are you off?
Oh yes, absolutely. My back is killing me. I can barely stand up right now.
Well,
because I mean the beanbag, because I hadn't been on it a while, I think it got unbroken in again, and it's been very hard to sleep on for me.
That mold where your body normally lays
exactly
is
the
gone.
The mold that grew back in or something. And it's not form-fitting to my body anymore.
Darn
so,
it.
Trust me, I'm probably going to get enough. It'll be form-fitting again by the time I get off of it, if you know what I'm saying.
Jeez, it's crazy.
You think it'll be 2022?
I don't, probably not, but probably a couple weeks.
I think it's wild how he's like still on the beanbag, especially like after he went home on Friday.
What do you mean?
you were in here. You say you were going to go home like right after. You said you were going to be home by 7, right?
Yeah.
What time are we home?
321-339-1055. I don't want to hear from you two today at all, period. Don't you think you hammered me enough on Friday?
No, we're just asking. We're trying to catch people up for what happened over the weekend.
I mean,
we don't have a weekend show, so you got to catch them up.
Yeah. What did you do Friday?
So what happened Friday? We know you went home.
I just, no, I didn't.
What time?
I mean, I just stayed out longer than
You went home eventually.
Yeah, I did. I eventually went home.
But what time did you get home? Approximately.
I don't know. I don't want to talk to either of you about this. I mean, we have important topics to get to today.
Exactly. This is very important.
No.
Nothing is more important.
In fact, Bubba the Love Sponge was calling you hot earlier on his radio show, but said your husband is huge, so he didn't want to say too much. Which is pretty true.
That's pretty funny.
He did say we were sitting at the coolest table at the JVC holiday party.
Yeah, I think we were at the cool kids table.
Sure. Yes. And then he apologized in advance to Shane Reeve, saying, I'm about to talk about your girlfriend Jenna as well. And he went on to talk about her.
Yes. Well, not specifically her.
Oh, yeah.
Not specifically.
A part of her.
Right, correct.
Parts.
Not specifically Jenna, but, you know. It's all good.
Now, were you the one rubbing on Bubba's?
No, that was definitely not me.
That
was not me. I won't. I know who he's talking about. I will not say the name because he obviously wasn't saying her name either.
No, well, he did give a big hint. He said high-ranking member.
Wow.
And he did say her husband was staring at him the whole time and with hatred. That's what it seemed like to me.
He said the only other guy that hated him was the HR guy.
Yeah. Who was that? Joey?
Joey.
Oh.
Joey.
Kneebreaker Joe. Why would Joey hate him?
Well, because I think he took his Yeti.
Oh,
that's
please.
Right. He did take the Yeti.
Yeah.
From Joey.
You can't get mad at someone stealing your gift in a white elephant holiday party gift giveaway. That's part of the fun of it, isn't it?
Yeah. I took two cups from Justin. I got flicked off. So,
well, no, you took the cups from me. The Yetis, the Wolf, and the Florida Man Yeti.
I think Justin took them from you because I took them from Justin.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, you did.
So I took them from you, and then Brianna took them from me. So, yeah. I mean, how did we all three get lumped together so closely where we could steal the Yetis from each other?
I'm not sure. I don't think we were in an order, though. I don't think we were in order. I think there was like one or two people between us.
Yeah, we did. Yeah.
We were close enough.
I will say those Yetis were pretty...
pretty nice.
Yeah,
those
pretty
are good.
Nice.
I was like, these are nice. I wasn't sure like which like who I wanted to steal from or just like go pick one, you know, and get stuck with something dumb. But you know, once I saw those, I was like, I'm definitely.
But
stealing
I'm okay
those.
With the toilet paper that I took. I'm good.
You got toilet paper.
Yeah, I got toilet paper.
But you got a gift card to toilet paper though, right? Oh, okay. I was like, I know someone did get toilet paper, but there was a gift card.
We did a gift giveaway at my law firm as well, and of course, because Polaris just had surgery, she wasn't out buying gifts for me, so I didn't take a gift at all. I had to pull out cash out of my pocket and use a wrapping that someone had just opened a gift with and wrapped $40. I just crunched it up like that and gave it to the guy.
Oh, who did you get?
Ali Asmar.
So he doesn't care. Though.
So I gave him $40, which is,
sure,
I mean, it was a $25 gift or whatever.
I'll
so $40 is pretty good.
Yeah.
But only because I didn't have a 10, I only had 20s.
Right.
But I wrapped it up in used wrapping.
Dallas had me, so he like.
What did he get
me.
You?
I don't know. I wasn't at the party, remember? So he reminded me several times at yesterday's, Saturday's party. He's like, I have your gift, so make sure you get it from me. And I was like, just leave it at my door. Like, I
got a basketball, I believe. I don't know where that is. Where is the? Who has my basketball, by the way? I have no idea where it is. Someone must have taken it home.
Could be in Castleberry.
Someone must have taken it home. I don't know. Certainly not me.
What time did the under one roof party finish on Saturday?
2 a.m. It was until the place closed.
Damn. He's at 2 a.m.
Yeah.
And were you there until 2 a.m.?
Yeah, when we were there longer. We sat outside on the front porch afterwards.
Jeez.
Yeah. It was a long night.
Damn.
It was just three parties in a row is a lot of work. It's a lot of work. What time did you leave?
Or like a lot of work?
I left at like at 10.
You left at 10 o'clock? Yeah. What about you, Brianna?
Yeah, I left about 10, 10:30.
Where did you guys, where did you go? Like, where did you have to be?
Home. What are you talking about? I got there like 6
something. Tired as hell.
You were just tired.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's been a long ass weekend. I'm tired.
And then we are supposed to have our radio show meeting tomorrow, I believe. Yeah. I really think we should bump that to next week.
Why?
Because I need to be home to like help around the house. Because my mother's been in town helping since Paula got her surgery, but she's leaving today. I have to go take her to the airport at like 1 o'clock today.
Okay.
So like tomorrow, I mean, I don't feel like I can go to work all day, go here and go to work and have a meeting after work. I feel like I need to go right home after work.
What about are you going to go right home after
of
work?
Of course.
What about Friday?
Can't say of course, like
why
you naturally go home.
I do every time.
Okay.
I don't do anything. Yeah, I'm getting so sick of hearing this. I don't ever do anything at all during the week.
Uh-huh.
Nothing. And you guys are like, ah, you're gonna go home. It's a Tuesday.
Right.
Well, I mean, I will always go straight home.
Never drink during the week.
Never. Absolutely correct.
It's not that. It's just the next day will come and we'll just ask you innocently, are you on the B-Bay? Yeah, I'm still on the B-Bay. I might have not come home, or maybe I did, maybe I didn't at this time.
You
like,
guys are so
you'll
wrong.
You'll say that, so then we're like, okay, well, obviously you went somewhere.
No, I never. I always go straight home during the week, without exception, really. Seriously.
Without exception.
Almost every single day, every single week, no matter what. Well, absolutely. I don't know where you're getting this information. It's wrong. It's incorrect information.
Incorrect information.
Just keep telling yourself that, buddy.
It's all good. We still love you, Justin.
No, I don't like this at all.
We still love you. Yeah. It's fine.
Denial. It's okay.
So we're gonna schedule it for what day?
I would think why can't we do next Tuesday?
Well,
because by that time,
hang on.
I work.
What days do you work?
Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday.
Ugh.
And then you got the holidays.
And then I'm off Thursday.
That's why this week was the best.
So what about Friday this week?
All right. I mean, I guess we can move it to Friday. Should be better by then at least. Tomorrow. No.
Friday's not good.
Why?
I have a party on Friday and Saturday.
Are you going to leave early from that party as well, like you did our own party?
Yeah.
Oh. So what day can
we... Why are you so upset when I got there 2 hours before you even got there?
Well, we got to figure out when to do this meeting, but I just feel like
we
I can't
did figure
do it.
It out.
I don't,
it was on
but I don't
Tuesday.
Think I can do it tomorrow. I feel like I have to go straight home to help with the kids.
Okay, that's it for me then.
What about
that's the only option you have?
That's the only option I have.
So what about the week after
Christmas? What about
the 28th, 29th?
Yeah, right.
Okay. 29th seems nice.
29th?
I think it would be nice. I think it was nice to have in the middle of the month, so like anything we want to start by the first, we can implement by the first.
Well, I know, but I have to go home. I don't
can
feel like
do
I can. I don't
a
feel
Zoom
like I can.
Meeting.
No, that's so stupid. I'm doing a Zoom creative meeting.
Come on, he's gonna pay for food.
Yeah.
I don't care for that. I really want to just make sure like the stuff gets done. You know,
I'm not doing a Zoom meeting.
All right, so on the air, I need you to confirm that if we do it the week of the 28th, a lot of things are not going to be implemented by the first.
I understand.
You need to be okay with that.
No,
and it needs
to
be able to be implemented the week after the first week.
All
of
right,
the year.
I'm good with that. No problem.
So the 29th, Tuesday the 29th.
But you said you have to work that day.
No, the week of Christmas.
Okay, Tuesday the 29th, done deal.
Okay.
Done deal. I'm in.
Let me move that to the calendar so I know.
But, that's fine, right? I mean, what's the problem? Because you're afraid we won't have enough time to implement some changes that we want to make? That's no big deal.
I don't care. It's fine.
It's no big deal right now.
Right. And then, why can't
Monday,
we implement it by the first? I don't understand. Blah, 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 blah. Yeah, we know. And I'm literally going to, tune. I'm going to tell Lurs to, cut your mic off. Like, nope, he has no, nope. No. And I'm just going to have him cut your mic off and play this audio from this conversation.
Let's hit your text messages. If you'd like to join us, 321-339-1055. Chase is here. What's up, Chase? How are you? Hey, gang. So I think I'm about to be on the beanbag tonight. I bought an expensive Xbox, and my wife won't let me enjoy myself. Any tips from a pro?
Xbox One X.
Xbox. Yeah, I mean, I think you just try to... You know, if she's going to say some nasty things to you, just try to ignore it and don't even respond. I think that's the best. That's what I do.
Now, here's tips from a pro. You should have brought the headset that goes with the Xbox, bro. Just tune your ass out. Just put that headset on and just.
I literally had to just. I just stopped. In fact, I just blocked the incoming text messages. It was so nasty. Whoa. I couldn't take it anymore. So I just blocked the messages coming in. That's what I did. Seriously.
Yeah, he's going to be on the beanbag till his birthday at least.
Ugly.
I don't think he's going to be on the beanbag. He's going to be on the porch.
It's a nice time of year to be on the porch, honestly.
It kind
of
is.
It's not hot out there. It hasn't been cold.
And then when you have to use the bathroom, what are you doing?
Pool. Hey, there's plenty of options there.
He's got a great pool.
I have a whole backyard and everything.
Go for a little dippy dip.
James is here. What's up, James? Morning, guys. Hope everyone's off the beanbag. By the way, nice party jacket you had, Justin, over the weekend. Thank you.
That's right.
Yeah, we won't see it again until next holiday season. But got a lot of compliments. But do you think people actually like my jacket or they hate it and they're just trying to appease me?
The people at the office make fun of it. I will tell you that. That is what I do know for sure. Everyone else, I can't speak for them. I can only speak for the people I hang around.
Yeah. Henry is here. Good morning, my guys. Worked yesterday, and it sucked that I didn't have a live show from you to listen to.
Oh.
Henry's working on Sundays.
Good Lord.
Chet is here. What's up, Chet? Morning, gang. Going to be a great day. Justin, where would you be without the great Brianna? Warned you about you heading to the beanbag. You'll get off it by Christmas, I believe. Y'all have a great day. Yeah. Later. I mean, you would think that, you know, around Christmas, probably off the
bit.
Yeah, you think it would soften up.
She'll soften up because the holidays.
So if I had to guess, probably like this whole week, I will be there at least.
Right, but by the end of next week, you're off.
Yeah, but I would say by mid next week, probably as Christmas gets closer, probably get off the beanbag.
And if you just like,
I don't know though. Who knows?
I think you'd be okay.
Yeah, I don't know. And then my mom kind of piled on yesterday too.
Your mom's pissed.
No, not pissed, but she wanted to talk as well. I was like, do you understand? Ooh. Don't you think I get enough talking to? You know, I don't necessarily need you piling on either. And not only that, you two a-holes sometimes pile on. You and piling on this week, too. Friday and now today.
I don't think we were piling on.
So I was in a horrible mood yesterday for a while.
But you got rest. So, I mean, I think that's...
I was in a terrible mood.
Decent.
For a while yesterday.
I mean, the truth hurts. I know.
Yeah.
Karen is here. Morning, friends. This show, the Justin Clark Show, where you have power show is like one big soap opera. I love it. Not really. I mean, it's not supposed to be.
Right. We don't have drama with each other. It's mainly just Justin's home drama. Yeah.
Mike is here. What's up, Mike? You have two blue falcons working for you. Put them on blast, brother. Hey. Keith is here. What's up, Keith? How are you? Good morning and happy holidays to you all. We love the show. Thank you, Keith. We love you. First virus vaccine was given out just moments ago up in New York. And, of course, Andrew Cuomo did it. He wasn't taking the vaccine. Oh. It was a healthcare worker, but did it during his press conference because, of course, he wants all the credit and credibility, right?
You know it.
He loves himself, this Cuomo. Mm-hmm. He loves himself, don't you think? And he had some bad news over the weekend, too. Some accusations being thrown around against him by a former employee. And she's saying it wasn't just her. She is saying there are a lot of people out there who have similar experiences with harassment from him. Let's put it that way. However, critical care nurse. What was her name here? Hold on. From the Long Island Jewish Medical Center in Queens received the first dose of the virus vaccine just moments ago. Sandra Lindsay was vaccinated during a Governor Andrew Cuomo press conference and was possibly the first to receive the jab in the United States as a whole. She said that she told the doctor administering the vaccine that she was feeling great and the shot didn't feel any different from any other vaccine. Yeah. Here's what she said. Hold on.
For your health services. So with that, Dr. Chester, we'll turn it over to you.
All right, here we go. Here comes the first shot.
How you feeling today?
It's a pretty big needle, by the way.
Is it?
Oh. Do you hate needles, or am I just kind of a wuss for my hatred of them?
I don't like needles.
You're a wuss.
Thank you.
I'm feeling great.
It's going in the arm.
I'm ready.
Going in the left arm. Here we go. Oh, it's a big needle.
That's really funny because I thought those cameras were like the needle acting like a drill. And I was like, how many times did you
get the cameras, yeah.
And then I was like, oh, wait, it's a press conference. There's, cameras.
Celebrating a big needle.
Celebrating a needle.
Wow.
Do you think you will get the vaccine or not?
Nah.
Not right away.
When will you be ready to get the vaccine? Next year, mid next year, late next year? What?
I mean, it depends. It's honestly not like the time is more so about. What is that?
What is that?
What is that?
That's you.
No, that's you, buddy.
Yeah, it's not him. He turned his down. all the way. Oh, that's strange.
That's you.
Oh, it's you.
I'm unplugged.
He's unplugged.
I'm totally unplugged here.
It's not me. It's host PC.
Oh.
What? Well, it's unplugged.
It is unplugged.
Look.
I'm looking at it.
You sure you're not on?
Let's take a quick break.
That's not me.
That's not me. I unplugged the thing.
He unplugged it and held it up.
It's not me. It's impossible.
Oh, it's still happening. That's
how. That's not me,
are
man.
You plug it back in.
That's not me.
Oh no, no.
Huh. What the hell?
Where's your phone?
Even the radio station doesn't like vaccines. No. So we start talking about a vaccine, and then all of a sudden everything goes to hell in a handbag.
Starts meditating on us.
It's unbelievable. I mean, seriously, the radio station doesn't even want me talking about this vaccine.
That's really weird.
They start sabotaging the program.
Huh. Look at that.
They start sabotaging our radio show.
Who knows?
We're going to a break. What are we going to do?
Unbelievable.
Okay.
You think it was a ghost?
If so, it's still happening.
You don't think Pilar did it, do you? I'm just saying.
I don't know. Maybe. Where was she at this morning? Oh, no.
3-2-1.
Yeah, who knows what it is?
I don't
it's
know.
Not a
339-1055. When we return. Many people in the country also suggesting that if you do go get your vaccination, you should be given a special mask so everyone around you knows that you have been vaccinated. What do you think of that?
Like an I voted sticker?
Yeah, like an I voted sticker. Come on. I don't think we're going to start labeling people, are you?
No.
We're going to start labeling you like the Nazi Germanys did with the Star of David, essentially?
Basically.
I mean, come on. It's a ridiculous idea. But we'll talk about that and plenty more. A quick break. Stick around. It's Justin Clark on the Florida Man Radio Network.
You're listening to You Have Power Radio with attorney Justin Clark.
Don't forget to call Home Security Alarm Experts. They are Central Florida's authorized ADT provider. And if you do so between now and the end of the year, I have a special offer for you. $850 value, all for free. Yes, they're giving you an alarm system for free. $850, Brianna, to have your house and your family protected. What an amazing offer. Thank you, Tom, Chris. Thank you, Home Security Alarm Experts, for protecting my house and my family. It's very simple. Here's what you need to do. Call my good buddy, Tom, Chris, right now at 844-517-0545, and you tell them you heard it right here, and they're going to give you this alarm system for free. Also, plenty of information, and you can sign up for this on the website, floridamanalarm.com. Lifetime warranty on your free alarm system. Check out Home Security Alarm Experts right now by going to the website, floridamanalarm.com.
Florida Man Radio. The Shannon Burke Show.
That's weird that the guy they busted at the party opposes equal rights for gay people and even proposed amending the Constitution in such a way as to guarantee that only heterosexual married couples will be able to adopt children. Then he went down to get his, banister polished by a young man, because I think he's a daddy. He's an older dude.
In fact, my ecstasy pills, damn you. These weren't yours, sir. I'll take them anyway. I've got immunity. God damn it.
The Shannon Burke Show. Afternoons from 3 to 7 on Florida Man Radio.
Tune into the Shannon Burke Show every Friday for Free Money Fridays, brought to you by Greens Energy Services. Win free green, plus save some green when you choose Greens Energy Services as your AC provider. Get all the details on how to win free cash every Friday at floridamanradio.com.
Every guy needs at least one sport coat or classic suit that fits well. Suit City of Orlando has changed it up to offer more styles to more men. Suits for any occasion. Weddings, prom, job interviews, holiday parties, even church. Suit City's holiday sale is going on now. Buy one suit and get the second 50% off. All blazers and shoes, 50% off. Men's dress shoes, $10 and $20 each. Tuxedos, sport coats, shoes, outerwear, shirts, and accessories. All discounted for the holidays. West Colonial Drive, suitcityoforlando.com.
Yes, it's healthier to take the stairs, but nothing beats jumping on the elevator. If you or someone you know is responsible for building management, maintenance, or selecting service vendors, write this down. Premier Elevator, 321-316-8558. Again, 321-316-8558. Premier Elevator is your vertical transportation expert. Monthly service and repairs, servicing all of Central Florida. PremierElevator.com. PremierElevator.com.
Stop paying high electric bills and upgrade the value of your home today with a solar power system from IQ Power Solar. It's never been easier. With no money down and financing options available, you'll be using the power of the sun to take back control of your power needs in no time. Get a free consultation and assessment of your home savings opportunities by calling IQ Power Solar today at 407-585-1018. Or to learn more, visit IQPowerSolar.com.
Say it with a shirt, the ultimate holiday gift for 2020. Custom t-shirts that are easy to design and priced right. No need for large orders or bulk purchases. Make your statement on a shirt for 2020 and get your instant message out on an affordable t-shirt that fits well and looks great. Go to theinstantmessage.com. That's theinstantmessage.com and start designing your custom shirt. It's simple and fast and will be the best gift that you give this year. Theinstantmessage.com will let you upload your own artwork, choose from over 100 clip art and fonts, and help you share your message on a shirt. TheInstantMessage.com is the ultimate 2020 holiday gift. Fast shipping, tons of colors and size combinations, and easy to design. Go to TheInstantMessage.com and use promo code JVC for a 15% discount. TheInstantMessage.com, promo code JVC. Say it in style. Say it with a shirt. TheInstantMessage.com, promo code JVC. Tune in weekly with Justin Clark during You Have Power for a new real estate segment, Real Sense, featuring Dawood Bedrosian from RE/MAX Town Center.
Hi, this is Dawood. I'll give you the facts on real estate trends as a buyer or seller, ways to find investments, what to look for when searching for a property or vacation home, flipping homes, owning versus renting, and how owning real estate is the cheat code to your success, plus a whole lot more.
Join us every Tuesday and brush up on all things real estate. Got a question? Call or text 321-339-1055 and get real-time responses. Real Sense, getting real on real estate with Dawood.
Four Seasons, your authorized trained dealer, was asked, what can you do to keep your home healthy and your AC in top condition? Number one, use a good pleated filter. Number two, ventilate, especially with low humidity and the fantastic temperatures right now. And number three, always keep your system maintained and clean. Contact Four Seasons AC at 4acnow.com. Four Seasons AC, the AC company you wish you called first. America's most trusted HVAC system. It's hard to stop a train. Four Seasons AC at 4acnow.com.
Get your fix of Florida Man Radio anytime and anywhere you are. Of course, you can catch Florida Man on 660 AM and 105.5 FM. But now you can listen wherever you are with the all-new Florida Man Radio app. And don't miss a second of the conversation at home by listening on your Alexa device. Just say, Alexa, play 105.5 Florida Man Radio. Florida Man is everywhere, unfiltered, unafraid. Get it how you need to, now. Now, back to You Have Power Radio with attorney Justin Clark.
The vaccine on its way. First dose administered this morning up in New York. 3 million doses were loaded onto trucks yesterday in Michigan. And sent via UPS and FedEx to 145 distribution centers today across all 50 states, with an additional 425 sites getting shipment tomorrow and the remaining 66 Wednesday. So it's here, no doubt about it. You know, right in time for New York City to close down their restaurants for all indoor dining again, by the way. Do they understand how many people are going out of business? How many livelihoods? How many people can't afford to pay for groceries for their children because of these shutdowns?
They don't.
It's crazy to me that they want to keep doing this. Absolutely insane that they want to keep closing down these restaurants. And I think about the restaurant workers, but also what about the owners of the restaurants who are not going to have any money left? Mm-hmm. Their kids aren't going to have a holiday season because we want to shut down all these restaurants. On the same day, we're sending out the vaccine. I mean, doesn't that mean we're closer to having the population okay now because we have a vaccine? I mean, that's what it's all about, isn't it?
That's if everyone takes it or most people take it.
What percentage of people are actually going to take it, you think? Half?
I would
maybe not
like
even
40%.
40% will take it.
40. Yeah, sounds about right.
But there's
and I know
also
they're showing these polls that say, you know, more than half want to take it, and like, but you just
I haven't
people.
I've actually never talked to someone who actually wants to take it.
Right. I, was like,
I have not talked to one single person who said I'm going to take this thing. Yeah.
See,
can't
like,
wait.
Like I said, I'll take it, but not right now. I want to know what side effects or what
true.
This is gonna, how this is going to affect people
am
right
I
away.
Am I going to turn into a corona? I need to know. And maybe.
Former Facebook executive Charmath Palihapitiya said Friday that he fully believes everyone who gets the vaccine should all wear a mask of a special design or color so everyone around them knows they have been vaccinated.
Wow.
The idea obviously not sitting well with most people on social media.
Well, yeah.
Who blasted him, like, left and right, including
special
me.
Special mask.
I mean, I didn't blast him on social. I blasted him in my head and now on the radio, I guess. Right. But comparing it to Nazis, Germany's use of the Star of David.
Yeah.
Which is true. What about back in the day whenever they found a woman who was who cheated on their husband, they would make them like get a tattoo of a or something?
The Scarlet Letter.
The Scarlet Letter. Yeah, there you go. I mean, okay. Well, whatever. You know what I'm saying.
Sure.
Isn't this the same concept in some ways?
Yeah, you're branding people who are different.
You're like branding people who are different.
Mm-hmm.
Or no,
whatever
or
reason they're different.
Or no, if you refuse to take the vaccine, what letter would we tattoo on their forehead? If you refuse to take the vaccine, what should we put on their forehead with tattoo?
R.
What, for refusal?
Or rejects, yes.
Rejects.
Or D for doofus.
Doofus.
They're probably right. Bad batch.
Oh, I don't know.
Are you going to get it?
No, of course I'm not getting the... No.
Never?
Are you crazy? I'm not going to go get this vaccine. No
are
your, way.
Are the kids getting it?
No. Are any kids getting it?
No. Are your kids getting
no.
it?
No.
Like, what if their school required them to get it?
Then I guess we're going to work from home. I don't know what to tell you. I mean, are any kids going to get it? I mean, kids are like the last people that are going to get this thing, right?
What if one parent says they're getting it and the other parent says they're not getting it?
Ooh,
who's going
happened?
To prevail?
Who knows? I have no idea.
I genuinely think, like, if Pilar is, like, for it, the kids are just going to get it and they just won't tell Justin because he's at work.
Other users also didn't see the point of having to continue to wear a mask when the vaccine's supposed to provide protection on its own. So is there that argument as well? Well, if you get the vaccine, you don't have to wear a mask anymore?
Yeah.
Because but now they're saying, well, it's not 100% effective,
right,
so...
Right, because there's people that get the flu vaccine and still, like, catch the flu. Yeah.
So we
know?
Still need you to wear a mask. What? I got to go get two shots and wear a mask still? That's ridiculous. I'm not getting two shots and still wearing a mask.
I mean...
What?
It's like getting the, you know, just because you get, like, the flu shot.
Yeah, and I don't wear a mask after I don't
right,
get the
but
flu shot.
You don't need the mask, but I'm saying it doesn't mean
I don't
you
get the flu shot either.
It doesn't mean you stop washing
shot?
Your hands.
Yeah, not since my mother would, like, drag me down to the doctor's office when I was a kid. No. I haven't gotten it as a grown adult when I could decide.
Right. The point I was making is just because, like, let's say you get the flu vaccine, it doesn't mean you stop washing your hands. Because,
yeah,
like, oh, I'm never going to get the flu. You know what I'm saying? Like...
Well, that's
still,
just disgusting.
You
yeah,
still take
I understand
precautions
that.
Against the things that could get you that the thing. You know what I'm saying?
No, I really don't because, yes, fine. You would take the flu shot and still wash your hands because it's just sanitary to wash your hands.
All right.
Especially after going to the restroom.
You wouldn't go lick the floor. Or you
no,
go, like,
but you wouldn't do that anyway. But I'm saying
go
if, you're gonna go, if you're going to drag yourself down to the doctor's office twice to get a needle in your arm.
Ugh.
Then surely you don't have to wear a mask anymore. For at least for 3 months, then what's the point?
I don't know.
What's the point of getting the vaccine if you still have to wear the mask?
So then what's the point of rolling out the vaccine if no one wants to get it?
That's a great question. Ask 60% of the country, I guess. Because it seems like most of the people I talk to do not want this vaccine at all. I'm not saying you should or shouldn't. I'm just saying most people that I know have said there's no way. Especially people my age or younger, who said there's no way they're going to go get the vaccine. I can understand maybe if you're older.
Yeah.
But, I mean, at my age, I don't know anyone my age that has had any serious complications from getting the virus, to be honest.
What if they say all lawyers have to get the vaccine or continue practicing law?
Then I guess I'm going to take some time off, Lurch. I don't know what to tell you.
He's really just going
to
lean into this radio thing, you know?
And I guess we need to get some more sponsors. Because
he's really just going to let law go at this point.
Let's hit your text messages. 321-339-1055. Chase is here. Oh, thanks, guys. I will definitely ignore her She knew I was getting one, but now she's acting like it's, she didn't know what was going on. Headset it is. So Chase is going to use a headset now for playing his new Xbox.
All right, Chase.
So well, you got to be careful. You're not going to hear her coming.
Uh-oh. Come upside that head.
Wait, hey, so I
get
thought
him,
they,
sis. Get him.
I thought they just released. I thought it was a PlayStation 5 they just released. There's a new Xbox out as well.
Yeah, PS5 and Xbox One X.
Yeah. So wait, this has just been released as well? Xbox One X? This is new? When did
Xbox
it get released? I haven't heard about it. Why are people not waiting in lines for this?
It came out a couple months ago. Hang on.
So is it impossible to get? Like, I mean, all these
really
other things?
It's not. He just got one.
Yeah, Chase, how did you score that? Because they were waiting in line for like days for the PlayStation 5, and no one could get them.
You can get them.
You could buy one right now, no problem.
Yep.
I don't understand this. Why did it take me a year to get a PlayStation 4, and I still wasn't able to get that?
You were looking for a Switch. You were looking for a PlayStation
4. Why did it take me a year for that, and now they released this new one, and everyone could get it, no problem?
Because
can I get a Nintendo Switch right now if I wanted to?
Probably not. And now,
why? So what? People don't like
the holidays.
People don't like Xbox?
No, it's not that. It's just that, like, Sony and Nintendo really, it's kind of like new shoes. They make a limited batch on purpose.
Dustin is here. Okay, so what happened this weekend? Did you redeem yourself and stepped it up as a husband?
No, of course not.
Or did you disappoint her even more? Dustin, I think you know the answer to that.
Come on. checking in, Justin.
Sean is here. Good morning, Justin and crew. Beanbag Nation here representing. He thinks that might be a gift from Premier Superstore in Shannon Sack that we heard humming before. Could
and
be.
If it was,
turn it
good
off.
Point.
Can't see it here. That was all on Justin's end. So you know what, whatever he's doing.
Speaking of Shannon Sack of prizes, you can register today. Go to floridamanradio.com and listen at 5:30. Shannon will be giving away a gift. Now we're also waiting to hear from Andrew Bennett from Friday. If we don't hear from Andrew by 5 p.m. today, the winner today at 5:30 will win two of Shannon's gifts.
Three?
We're 3 days in on this one.
Snappity.
Wow.
Appity app.
Wow.
I don't get it. If you sign up and you know when to listen, why don't you listen and win the prize?
I don't know. But if you're Andrew Bennett and
you better figure it out, baby.
In Kissimmee.
Yeah.
You got till 5 o'clock today. You've got two prizes from Shannon's sack of prizes. Waiting on you. Unbelievable. Karen is here. What's up, Karen? Cuomo just wants another Emmy, or maybe he's doing it for an Oscar. You're probably right. My mother-in-law wants to take it. She wants to be first in line or second now to take it. Let's see here. Lee checks in. What's up, Lee? How are you? What if Mayor Cuomo kicks the bucket now? Well, I think that a lot of people aren't going to want to take the vaccine, obviously. Also, an L for loser on your forehead or a question mark on your forehead if you do take it. Okay. Bebby is here. Good morning to all. Thank you, guys. All need to take a rest from all the parties. Be safe. Love listening. Thank you. We are. I mean, the one good thing about my parties is we got them all out of the way. Boom, boom, boom. I'm done.
You're done?
3 days in a row. Boom, boom, boom. I'm done.
It's my last weekend. Then I'm done.
You have more coming up this weekend.
Yep. And then that's it.
Like, what kind of parties are this weekend? Is that a little close to Christmas? I feel like the party should have been over this weekend.
I'm sorry.
Okay. What parties do you have this weekend?
Sorry that you feel that way. I got stuff for church, my friends' parties. I got other stuff, other businesses.
I imagine that your church parties are slightly different. Are slightly different than my parties.
Yeah.
A little bit. Dustin said, what's the plan now? Beanbagging it forever? Splitsville? Or making it up to her? I don't know. Beanbag for a week or so. Probably.
Hopefully she forgets.
Chase!
How would you try to bring it up to
her? Making it up to her is not an option.
The new Xbox is called the Series X. It's sold out and hard to get. I pre-ordered one and got lucky. The One X that Lurch was stating was the last generation console.
I meant
console.
To say Xbox Series X.
Yes. Xbox Series X is the new one. So it is hard to get. You can't just roll up into the local
everywhere.
Walmart and get an Xbox.
Pre-ordered and got lucky. I mean,
sold out everywhere.
But it looks like, Chase. Okay, good.
Just wait maybe 3 months and then.
You know, they always, they sell out at Christmas. They sell out when they first get it, but you'll get one third week of January. You'll be all right.
What is your favorite breakfast for Christmas morning? Do you have a certain breakfast that you always will make on Christmas morning? And you all eat together as a family or no?
That's cute. No.
What's typical? What do you typically do? Do you normally celebrate Christmas on Christmas Eve evening or Christmas Day?
It depends who I do Christmas with.
Lurch.
Christmas Eve evening.
I mean, at least in the Colombian world, they all do Christmas Eve.
In the Latin American world,
like Christmas Day. I just didn't want to overgeneralize. You know, I don't want to get in trouble here. But I'm just saying. Here's how it really goes. So my Colombian family, they always celebrate Christmas Eve. I'm not generalizing it to an entire population of people, but Christmas Eve is a big, big night. In my Colombian family, I would say. Christmas Day, they don't do anything Christmas Day. I mean, you make like a big breakfast, like the garbage breakfast or whatever they call it. Like all the leftovers, you put it into like a breakfast the next day.
Right.
And that's what we do. However, if Florida has its way, snake and eggs might be replacing steak and eggs. Have you ever tried snake? Have you ever eaten snake?
Nope.
Yes.
Has anyone here ever eaten snake? Anyone in Beanbag Nation eaten snake?
Yep.
When have you eaten snake and why?
Ate snake last year when I was camping at the Grand Canyon.
Okay. I got a restaurant or caught a snake?
No, it was rattlesnake.
Open fire.
Yeah, like they have, it's like a Native American owned restaurant. And they were like, the guy brought it to our table. He's like, yeah, we catch it every day. And I was like,
you tend to believe Nighthawk, your trail guide?
No, but I feel like our waiter doubled as a trail guide for some, if you know what I'm saying.
Dustin said, my wife would dump me in the dumpster if I pulled a Justin. You got to admit, you're effed up, man.
Oh.
And what's left of your Colombian family.
Ooh.
Damn. People are harsh to me.
Are they harsh?
Yes.
Or is it just,
I mean, it's harsh.
Or does the truth just
and
read?
Truth, yeah.
No, that's harsh.
Really, really hurts.
No, that's harsh.
Yeah. That's harsh.
No, it was kind of harsh, though.
So there's this lady named Donna Khalil.
Okay.
She's a python hunter.
Oh.
She says she's eaten more than a dozen pythons in the last 3 years or so, not including the python jerky as well. But now state officials in Florida would like to see more of you putting pythons on your menu.
Why?
Not because of nutritional value, but as a way to encourage hunting pythons to further control their population.
Oh, here we go.
According to the spokesperson for the Florida Fish and Wildlife Conservation Commission, we would like to use consumption as another way to encourage people to remove pythons in Florida if the meat is safe to eat. What? Don't you think we should figure out if it's safe first before you start recommending it?
No.
No, just go right in. What kind of snake did you eat?
They didn't do that
with
the vaccine.
What kind of snake did you eat?
Rattlesnake.
Like a straight up rattler.
Yep. Yep.
And I'll
post some videos.
Did you like it?
It was decent. It was decent.
What did it taste like?
Not chicken. For sure. It definitely tastes like rattlesnake.
Like beef jerky?
It tastes like rattlesnake.
It was fried. It definitely tastes like rattlesnake. You know, I had to use the sauce. I had to dip it in some blue cheese to get the...
What do you prefer, alligator or snake?
Gator. I love gator.
You do love gator?
Yeah, I'll eat the hell
Have
out
you ever
gator.
Eaten gator?
I've had, I think, like a gator bite.
Like one little bite?
What do you mean, one bite?
Can you get... You can get gator bites at some mainstream restaurants in Florida,
yeah,
can't
you? You can get it from Gators. Or Gators, Froggers, sorry.
At Froggers, they have it.
And Gators, but yeah,
well,
Froggers.
Well, at the Hyatt, McCoy's, the restaurant there,
They had gator on the menu.
Mm-hmm.
And you just tried one bite.
Was it fried or?
Yeah.
That's the only way you eat gator, isn't
it?
Fried.
Raw.
Look, I don't know.
Raw gator.
I don't know if you can like bake it. I don't know. I've only had it fried. I just don't know other ways that you can make it.
I have never eaten. I mean, I think the only reason I would ever eat snake, maybe if I was on the Naked and Afraid show.
It was really chewy.
I think that would be the only way I would ever eat gator if I just had to. Like I was about to die.
If we were in a, apocalypse, and that's all that was left.
Or if I was on a game show and they were like, "We give you $1 million, eat this whole python."
Like Fear Factor.
Man.
Other invasive species are consumed in Florida, most notably lionfish. You've heard about lionfish. They're trying to get rid of these lionfish, and so they're trying to convince people to eat them. And I've seen lionfish on some restaurants, but I think lionfish also is poisonous or something if you don't cook it right or what. There's something about lionfish that's poisonous.
Oh, I've seen those. Oh, okay.
However, there might even be a bigger concern about eating pythons because the massive snakes, like some fish, could be full of mercury.
Yeah.
Mercury's bad.
Yeah, it is.
I think we all found out mercury was bad whenever our parents would take our temperature growing up and with those old school thermometers, you know? And it was that had the mercury inside of it, and you always would worry about it breaking and somehow getting in your... And your system?
Right.
Mercury, bad, for sure. In fact, the EPA said that the safe limit for mercury is 0.3 parts per million.
Shouldn't it just be zero?
Right, just none.
0.3 parts per million. However, some of the pythons found in the Everglades register more than 100 times that.
This isn't it.
Hundreds of parts per million.
And the python hunter has...
Yeah, she's full of mercury at this point.
Right.
I'm not worried about that mercury.
Right.
It's natural.
Did her foot fall off?
Right, yeah.
Mid-sentence.
Who cares about a little mercury? Really, lady? 100 times more than the recommended dose of mercury in your snake soup?
Do you think we can try to track her down and get her on the show?
Sure.
What's her name?
Let me tell you. Khalil. K-A-L-I-L is the last name. First name, Donna.
Okay. No, I'm good at finding people.
Python is pretty good in chili, she says. Also like it my stir fry.
Found her.
But her favorite way to eat python is to pressure cook it for 10 to 15 minutes, saute it with onions and garlic, and add it to pasta and a sauce. It's snake pasta. What?
I have a question.
Yeah.
What's the people that the Florida Fish and Wildlife, what do they say about this?
They said, and I quote, "We would like to use consumption as another way to encourage people to remove pythons in Florida if the meat is safe to eat." So, yes, they're basically recommending it without knowing if it's a good idea or not. I don't know. I don't know if it's time to make that statement quite yet. But her favorite way to eat it is in pasta. She gave up her real estate job to hunt pythons full time.
Parmesan cheese.
She said that she said the meat is rubbery and tough if you don't prepare it properly.
You don't say.
The pressure cooker makes it more tender, though. I don't really want to say it's like fish because it's more the texture of fish. But it definitely does not taste anything like fish. It tastes more like chicken. Or actually, maybe more like a pork chop, she says.
Put it in the air fryer.
Oh, yeah, you can put anything in the air fryer, I think, right?
Yes.
Well, we use the air fryer at my house all the time.
Same.
It seems like they cook everything in there.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Eunice is using the air fryer.
She uses it a lot now, too? What is she making it?
Chicken, bacon.
Everything.
Yeah, everything.
I'm for one, not ready to eat python. Or any snake, for that matter.
Not even if as a radio stunt.
We definitely will, because I just reached out to Donna, so she's going
to... Oh, really?
She's going to come on the show, and we're going... I mean, the thing is, like, she lives in Miami, so she probably won't come on the show.
She can call in.
She can call in. Maybe we can have some meat ready. She can find us, like, she can let us know where we can get some meat in Orlando, and we can make it up and have it ready for her.
We'll go.
I would try it as a radio deal, just one bite of it. You would try one bite, probably, wouldn't you?
One bite.
So how big are the, when you had the rattlesnake in wherever you were, how big are the chunks?
It was like a nugget size, basically.
It's like
it was really chewy.
Snake nugget.
I was really happy that they made them kind of small because it was like chewy. Like it was like kind of like steak, how it expands in your mouth. It's like, man, this is, the more I chew this thing, the bigger it's getting. And I don't think I like that. So yeah, it's really.
Well, you'll have a tender. I'll have a nugget.
How many pieces did you eat?
It was an appetizer. So we split it. We ate the whole thing.
So this wasn't a main dish. This was just an appetizer. And you were just doing it to like be cool.
No, just doing it because we've never had rattlesnake before.
Nighthawk.
How much does a rattlesnake appetizer cost?
I can't remember. It was last year. I have no clue.
Ugh.
No clue.
What else is on the menu there?
You know, eagles and
trout. Eagles.
No. Joking. No, they. Oh. It's like a,
they're
not
a bald eagle. Those things.
Regular restaurant. You know, they had they did have bison on the menu, so they did have like bison and lamb and. You know, but other than that, like, I think that was, like, the weirdest thing on the menu.
I was in Montreal for my buddy from law school's wedding. This is a decade ago now, I would say. And I was choosing the restaurant for the bachelor party, I guess, the night before the wedding.
Hey.
And I chose this restaurant that looked awesome. It was called Restaurant DNA. And it was a beautiful place. Beautiful restaurant. However, the DNA refers to, it was just, like, all weird-ass, like, parts of animals and things. It was disgusting. I was very disappointed in my choice.
It's called restaurant.
Yeah, it's probably long gone now. And they also had seal on the menu. They had seal, which are like a very protected species, I think.
I've never had seal.
Yeah.
Goliath grouper was on the menu as well.
No.
Oh, right. Jesus.
Yeah.
The hell?
I mean, seal is bad.
Why not chop up some koalas and put them in there? Good lord. The hell? Put seal on the menu?
Yeah, I could hardly eat anything on that menu. And everyone was like, oh, good choice, Justin. Meaning, like, you're an idiot.
So it was a Mediterranean restaurant.
Scales. No. Definitely not Mediterranean.
Jeez. I mean, yeah, it's probably close. He said it was a decade ago. Here. I mean, let's be honest.
Yeah. Definitely changed.
It says French Mediterranean.
Yeah, they had to wise up because they weren't going to stay open with that current menu.
Dave the drummer checks in. Good morning, Dave. Good morning, gang. Sorry your mom is going back home today. I was hoping we would get to meet her. The ball busting has begun, buddy. It's not looking good for Justin. I agree.
Yeah.
I'll also take a hard pass on trying Python, but have had Gator, which was delicious.
Gator was nice.
I don't love Gator either, but compared to Rattlesnake... it sounds fantastic. Gator's fine. I mean, it's okay.
I'll post my pictures of the rattlesnake meat. There's a video.
You still
of,
have
like,
it somewhere?
It. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, where is it? Why can't we see it now?
Because it was a year ago. It's in my phone, so I got to swipe for a while to get there.
So when it came out, it just came out chopped up already? And they didn't like come out with the actual
like the whole snake
and then chop it up? And
because it's like it's a meat, so you know like once you cook it, it shrinks.
Jeremy in Lakeland's here. What's up, Jeremy? I had rattlesnake queso at Buckhorn Exchange in Denver. It was good. I'd like to try it by itself to get a better idea of the flavor. This restaurant is a must stop when in the other city. Beautiful.
I see.
But rattlesnake queso, I mean, that's kind of...
Right, it's a sauce.
That's like packing it in, I think, a little bit. That's not really trying rattlesnake.
He said he wants to try the whole thing, though. He wants to try, like, the raw, the snake.
Justin wants to have the snake here. And
Justin wants to, right. He wants to eat the snake, let it bite him, you know.
Lee checks in. What's up, Lee? How are you? I reckon we're in kind of the same boat, buddy. My daughter's mama is Dominican, and she's mean like the Dickens. and is always mad by default. Plus, the abuela lives with us, too. I don't have a beanbag, but I do have my own mother-in-law suite. So it sounds like Lee spends a lot of time in the mother-in-law suite as well.
The Dickens.
Let's see. Here was this. 407 checks in. I will be getting vaccinated as a preventative measure for myself and as a measure to help prevent community spread of the virus. I don't understand how patriotism is defined only as ultimate individualism as opposed to striving collectively for the good of our countrymen. I can understand that argument, too. Yeah. I understand what you're saying. It's just me in particular. I don't like needles. I don't get the flu shot. Ugh. I don't go to the doctor, period. Mm-hmm. I'm not getting the vaccine. I mean, I'll still wear my mask through the threshold of the door, or if I go to a store that requires a mask, I'll put it on. I'm not going to go complain. Mm-hmm. But I, for one, am not going to go get that vaccine.
Yeah,
I'm not.
I wouldn't.
I'm not going to do it. I don't get the flu shot.
I'll wait.
I don't get this one. And I'm not saying that I have any problem with people. I guess a lot of people do. I just haven't talked to anyone who really wants to get it, except, I mean, you, unfortunately.
Who?
Oh, now I'm seeing a video of eating rattlesnake.
Yeah.
Jeez.
It's tangy. It's really chewy.
Ugh.
And this is the pieces that it came in. So it came in like these little chunks.
Disgusting.
And you can see the ripples of like, you know, because it's a snake. It's real thin. So it's not a lot of meat. But, and that's how it came on the plate.
What other animals out there are poisonous that we still eat?
Swipe that way.
I mean, I think lionfish are poisonous, I believe. Rattlesnake certainly has venom.
Sea urchin.
Mm-hmm. They're poisonous.
Yeah, they're poisonous. And you have to be, like when we were in Japan, they told us, like, don't just get sea urchin off the street. Like, only certain people are allowed to even cook it.
Really?
Because of how poisonous it is. So it's pretty, like, yeah. It's
really and see, I know, I understand that in fine dining, sea urchin is, like, really cool. And you have to act like you like it. But can I be honest with you? I don't like it.
No.
Sea urchin, it's that orange thing, right? There's another name for it.
Yeah,
sea urchin is that orange, like, soft. Yeah. Ugh. Like, if you go to a really nice Japanese restaurant, they will always put sea urchin on your plate. And you have to act like you like it if you're around fancy people. But I don't like it. I'm gonna be honest with you right now. I don't like it.
What about the puffer fish?
Do you like it?
What?
No,
sea
like
urchin.
It. I didn't like it.
It's the orange thing. I know exactly what it is.
Yes.
But I don't like it. But you have to, if you act like you're like a dining connoisseur, you have to act like you like it. But I really don't, deep down.
I didn't like it at all. I didn't even pretend like I liked it.
Oh, I pretend like I like it. Because especially when the chef's around, you have to act like you like it. But uni, thank you, Dustin. Uni, that's what it is.
So here says pufferfish can be lethally poisonous. It says the ovaries, intestines, and liver of the pufferfish contain tetrodotoxin, a neurotoxin up to 1,200 times more deadly than cyanide. Would you try that?
Like mad poisons.
It says Japanese chefs must undergo years of training to obtain a pufferfish preparing license.
Yep.
It says, despite these precautions, numerous people die every year from improperly prepared puffer fish.
Because they like, buy them from like street vendors. Like, do, but they do they sell? Told us, they were like, do not buy them from like just any guy on the street.
Do
like,
you get puffer fish in America, though? I don't think I've ever seen it on an American menu. Have you? I mean, I haven't been to every restaurant in America, of course, but I just it's not something I hear about here quite often.
No.
Jeremy checks in. What's up, Jeremy? The vaccine does nothing to stop community spread, causing the high participation numbers for effectiveness. Huh. I don't know.
Well, it says here.
What? Puffer fish?
No. Oh. Sinakji, a Korean dish, is live baby octopus tentacles that are cut into pieces, seasoned, and served immediately. It says culinary daredevils eat the tentacles while they are still writhing on the plate, which is a very dangerous game.
Yeah.
Suction pads on the tentacles maintain suction even after the tentacles are severed. So diners must chew the tentacles before they stick to the roof of the mouth.
Yeesh.
Why the hell would you even try to do that?
I don't know. I might just stick with grouper at that point.
Right. Now you got to fight your food just to eat it. Go down.
Six people choke and die from eating or attempting to eat the baby octopus each year.
Fish is here. Good morning, fish. Good morning, peeps. Puffer fish tail is really good. I know how to cook them. I've never gotten sick. Hmm. Okay.
So he's licensed. licensed and insured.
Yes. I mean, why don't you start by making me some grouper fish?
Start there. Start small.
I'm not ready to go right to puffer fish. No, thank you. Where do you get it? Can you, like, catch them in the ocean here? Is this a local fish? Fish? I just don't know. I've never seen puffer fish at the store.
Puffer fish, and it may be associated with Japan, so I would assume maybe you get it in Japan.
You think so? Hey, fish, where did you get puffer fish? Did you catch it yourself? And, any sort of recipe I'm good with, I have no problem following a recipe. But when part of the recipe says, and if you don't do this, you're going to sicken everyone in the house. You know, I don't know. I don't know if I want to do that. Mm. Or they could die.
Yeah.
Really?
Worse.
Yeah.
Not just get sick.
Turn the oven to 425. If you leave it at 375, everyone might die in the house.
Right. Kill your family. Whole family.
You just poisoned your family with puffer fish.
Meanwhile, Pilar's over there looking at puffer fish.
Stop it.
Hey, guys, guess what? I have puffer fish to dinner tonight.
No. This is Daddy's special plate.
That's messed up.
I'm sorry.
That is messed up.
That's so funny.
What would you do?
Dustin's
going to
get angry with you. What?
If you were to get home and puffer fish is on the menu.
There's a puffer fish and a Gatorade.
Right. She's like, how's this prepared? Don't worry about it. Yeah. I'm concerned.
And a snake.
Puffer fish and a funny tasting Gatorade. Right. Never a good idea.
Gatorade has been hanging out for a couple days to
this
get tangy for
Gatorade says
you.
Fruit punch, but it looks more like grape.
Oh.
I'm sorry. It's just so funny.
You guys are so messed up to me. Like, I don't get it enough. Oh. I mean, really? Do I really deserve this right
well,
now?
Well, you obviously don't get it enough.
Man. Well, obviously. I don't know. That's funny, though.
Well, at least she's not applying for a concealed permit weapon or whatever now.
Yeah,
concealed weapon permit, I should
say. She's only hiding them in your Amazon cart.
Yeah.
But if she did, she would be one of a record-setting amount of Floridians who have applied for a concealed weapon license. In October of this year, more people in the state of Florida than ever in its history applied for concealed weapons licenses. Why is this right now?
I think people are just...
Are we doing it?
I think the left, the right's like gearing up. I think, there's people that know that there's people that just don't have guns and there's people that are going to need guns. And I think the writing's on the wall and just it's time to arm up.
38,349 new CWL applications in October. In addition to the 8,590 renewal applications in October, an all-time record, there have been at least 36,000 new applications every month since July of this year. So it's way up since July. What was going on in July?
Riots.
Right.
I thought that was May. June, I believe.
Started, and I think like maybe around July when people saw they weren't stopping. They
they are expecting 305,000 new applications this year and 143,000 renewal applications in 2020. The all-time record was 202,000. So over 100,000 more than normal.
See, when I got to renew.
In 2018, there were 188,000 applications. So like half, basically.
Are you going to be one of them or no?
I don't think so. No. I know. I should have a gun in my house or whatever, but it's just, I don't know. It makes me nervous with little kids.
Yeah, that's true.
And other things.
You can just keep it all the way up and other things.
I'm just saying. Kids. Kids. I'm
sick of. You guys are so messed up for saying that. It's also kids and other things.
Kids.
Would you rather
mainly the kids.
Try getting the gun, or would you rather try the puffer fish? Which one would you?
I would rather take my chances with the puffer fish, clearly.
Eat this puffer fish real quick.
I've never liked puffer fish so much.
Let me see something. Sorry, that's so funny. Yeah.
You guys are messed up.
Now you're the one.
Puffer fish, yes, definitely puffer fish. I mean, rattlesnake, whatever.
Yeah, all of them. Yeah. Yes, the answer is yes.
I mean, how do you hide guns from children? I mean, that is a scary combination, of course.
Yeah.
What do you think?
I mean, you put it high. Like, when I say high, I mean, like, can they get to the top of the refrigerator? You know what I'm saying? Like, you got to put it somewhere high, but accessible
put it in
to
a safe.
You. A lot of people lock them in safes.
Yeah. Well, only you know the number.
A lot of people also just educate their kids on guns, and I think that's a very, very large part of it. Like, I grew up with guns in our house, and my dad was very, very specific about when we can touch the gun and when we cannot touch
the
gun, you know? And we never had, I mean, obviously, we're all still here. We all have our fingers in our heads. So, you know, except for that one sibling.
Of course, Fish checks in. With a picture of him with a puffer fish.
Uh-oh. Let me see.
There are puffer fish you can eat and catch all around. So you can get them locally, I guess.
Look at that guy.
They have to be a decent size. Cut the head, pull the guts out, and rinse the tail meat. Very tasty.
That bitch is ugly.
So what is
That's
this?
An ugly fish.
That's an ugly
fish. So what is
fish?
This whole years of training and license and all that?
No, those are sea urchin.
No. I was in the sit here for the puffer fish.
Oh, okay. Japanese
chefs must undergo years of training to obtain a preparing license.
I guess he said there's like ones you can that are not poisonous.
Lee said, keep it safe, kids, and load up on Nerf guns instead.
Hey. That'll
Is
get
that
the robber.
Kind of gun you do have?
Hey, we do have Nerf guns around the house. I'm okay with those.
That'll keep the robber away.
Yes.
Coming at you, buddy.
Dustin's still coming hard at me today.
Oh, is he?
You act like a victim a lot.
Uh-oh.
Do you even have any remorse? You act like it's funny and something to be proud of.
Oh, Jesus. Any statement from you, Justin?
Do
Blake?
You?
Not really. I mean, I want to say something back, but...
Let's not.
We might want to do the uncensored version of the show, and I'll talk back at that point.
Well, that's not starting on January 1. You people don't know what's up.
James believes you don't have to hide the guns at all. Like B said, you educate and just keep properly locked.
Yep. We never touched them guns.
You did not?
Mm-mm.
What would your dad have done growing up if he saw you played with a gun? What would he have done to you?
Pistol whip?
Yeah, he probably would have, like, you know, grabbed it and, like, made us put our mouth around the barrel and
what?
Say, I'm joking, obviously.
Oh, it wasn't obvious, because...
Clearly, he'd never do that, but I mean, like, I don't know, like, we really respected him as a person, you know, so when he said, don't touch these are not toys, we know that guns are not toys. And, like, just holding it, as a child, holding an actual gun is, like, it's actually scary enough itself.
Yeah, it's scary.
Yeah, I remember the first time I held a gun, I was like shaking and like it was empty. Like it didn't even have the clip in. It was empty as hell. And I was like still shaking. And my dad was like, all right, we don't look into the barrel of the gun, but let's look into the barrel of it. And I remember like it was like ice in my veins. It was so scary. And I was like, I am never touching that thing. That thing is.
Have you ever touched a gun, Justin?
Yeah.
Yes, I have touched a gun before. I think I shot one when I was like 7 years old with my uncle, actually, one time. I think that's the only time I've ever shot a gun.
And that did it. Like,
oh, no. Actually, like 2 years ago, I held my buddy's AK-47 or something.
Oh,
like,
dang.
It was like it was an intense gun. I don't know if it was AK, but it was.
One of those assault rifles?
It was an assault rifle for sure.
Oh, okay.
I think there's a picture of me floating around somewhere holding it.
You gotta find
it. But I didn't shoot it. We were in my buddy's backyard. I held it.
So you don't remember ever shooting?
I think I was 7 years old. I shot a little handgun at a Pepsi can.
No, the 2 years ago. Or the your
No, I did not shoot it. I just held it. I know I didn't shoot it.
And what did you say? And?
You got to take a break. When we get back, the Cleveland Indians are no more. They are officially dropping the name Indians from their name after 105 years or something like that. It's crazy. We'll talk about that and plenty more. Quick break in the news. It's Justin Clark on the Florida Man Radio Network.
You're listening to You Have Power Radio with attorney Justin Clark.
We do not have guns in my house, but my house is protected by my good friends and home security alarm experts, and you can protect your home as well. And if you do it between now and the end of the year, they are going to give you a free, yes, you heard it here, free alarm system worth $850. And the cost of monitoring every month, less than the cost of my gym membership. And I go to a pretty inexpensive gym. And it makes me feel great knowing that my family is protected during the day. Do me a favor. Go to floridamanalarm.com right now. Or call Tom Crest at 844-517-0545. 63% of break-ins occur during the day. Who's watching your family while you're at work? I know who's watching mine. It is my good friends and home security alarm experts. Again, floridamanradio.com or call 844-517-0545.
Florida Man Radio.
Previously on the Bubba Love Sponge Show.
No. Oh, last pick.
Oh, damn it. Man.
I thought I had, I'm sorry. I thought I had one more pick.
I think 4 by 100 is pretty much self-explanatory. There's four total people. You've picked three plus you equals how many, Danny?
That's four.
Four.
Yep. You got 800 on math on the SAT. You don't know four, man?
I and there was nobody
I mean,
left,
this is
so.
Like,
God,
this
I hope
is
you don't
like
have surgery today.
Bubba the Love Sponge, morning 6 till 10 on Florida Man Radio.
Are you a business owner? Well, first of all, thanks for listening. If you want to find new customers, we can help on Orlando's newest radio station, WDYZ Florida Man Radio, 105.5 FM, 660 AM. Your ad could be featured right here in the morning with Bubba the Love Sponge. Key placement 10 till noon in You Have Power Radio with Justin Clark. Noon till 3 with the Ed Till Show. Or in Prime PM Drive during the Shannon Burke Show. We can create a custom campaign based on your goals and budget. Drive store traffic, engage new clients, develop more leads, boost website activation, and get your cash registered to ring with new business. Radio gets results, and JVC Broadcasting is ready to help take your business to the next level. For more information on increasing your success, visit our website at floridamanradio.com and click on the Advertise tab. Drive store traffic, engage new clients, develop more leads, boost website activation, and get your cash registered to ring with new business. Let us help you grow your business.
Reach out today, unfiltered, unafraid. floridamanradio.com. Click on the Advertise tab. Do it now.
A new tradition is born. Original Orlando Tours presents the Winter Park Old Fashioned Christmas Cruise. Or safely join with friends and family for one of our 10 foodie, ghosts, history, trivia, or celebrity local walking tours. Space is limited, so reserve now at originalorlando.com.
This is Sergeant Slayer. Attend. Today's orders are to go to WeKillFloridaBugs.com. Say it again.
WeKillFloridaBugs.com.
WeKillFloridaBugs.com is home of Mighty Tech Pest Management. Get in touch with Mighty Tech today for residential and commercial pest control, termites, wildlife exclusion, and removal. And if mosquitoes are a problem, ask Mighty Tech about them as well. Call for a free evaluation today. 1-888-750-7378.
Say it again.
WeKillFloridaBugs.com.
Dismissed.
If you've been involved in a car accident, call me, Mark Anajar, at the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733. And take back control of your life.
Office in Orlando.
Instead of leaving your woman disappointed and unsatisfied, wouldn't you like to rock her world again? You need peak performance for men. No pills, no needles, no pumps, no surgery, no downtime, no pain. It's new, proven effective, non-invasive way to treat ED. And 90% of the guys that get it have much happier partners. 407-464-8181. It's 407-464-8181. Go to peakperformanceformen.org for more information today.
Stop paying high electric bills and upgrade the value of your home today with a solar power system from IQ Power Solar. It's never been easier. With no money down and financing options available, you'll be using the power of the sun to take back control of your power needs in no time.
Get a free consultation and assessment of your home savings opportunities by calling IQ Power Solar today at 407-585-1018. Or to learn more, visit IQPowerSolar.com.
Get your best deal on a Nissan in December and shop 24/7 at BillRayNissan.com. Deals like a 2020 Nissan Kicks for just $15,870 or 2020 Nissan Sentra for only $173 a month. Bill Ray Nissan, Highway 1792 Longwood and BillRayNissan.com.
Tis the season and Four Seasons AC wants to wish you a very happy holiday. There's only 11 days left till Christmas. This countdown to Christmas powered by your authorized trained dealer, Four Seasons AC. Online at 4acnow.com. It's hard. Hard to stop a train.
Good morning. I'm News 6 reporter Crystal Moyer. Here are your Monday morning headlines. A historic time in the fight against coronavirus. Today, Advent Health Orlando is expected to get its first doses of the Pfizer vaccine. The hospital says they plan to give the shots this week to doctors and frontline workers who are most at risk. In a deadly scene on the water after one person died following a boating accident on Lake Jessup, fire officials say the victim drowned after their boat overturned yesterday. Firefighters say a person on shore managed to pull the boater out and attempted CPR, but it was too late. And former UCF quarterback Mackenzie Milton is trading his black and gold for garnet and gold. He announced over the weekend he is officially transferring to Florida State University. Milton led the Knights for nearly three seasons until a devastating knee injury sidelined him in 2018. Remember, you can get breaking news around the clock on clickorlando.com and the News 6 app.
WDYC, Altamont Springs. WYGC, High Springs.
A JVC broadcasting station.
660 AM, 105.5 FM.
Florida Man Radio.
Now, back to You Have Power Radio with attorney Justin Clark.
Hour number two begins. Brianna's here. Lurch is here. Beanbag Nation in the house. If you want to join us, it's 321-339-1055. Hey, don't forget to go to our website, floridamanradio.com, and register to win a prize from Shannon Sack of prizes. You got to listen today at 5:30. He will announce the winner. And if we don't hear from Andrew Bennett from Kissimmee before 5 p.m., the winner today gets three prizes from Count Shando Sacco. Three prizes. Where are you, Andrew Bennett?
I know.
You better call in. Hey, what does Andrew need to do? Text, call, anything? Like, just to let us know he knows?
Smoke signal? Yes. Like, dang, bro. Like, just let us know.
A smoke signal works or no? I didn't read the official rules.
Go to my office.
Yeah. Nah, don't go to my office.
Batman signal in the sky? I don't care.
Don't go to my office unless you've been vaccinated. I'm going to put a big sign on my office. You're not allowed to come in unless you've gotten the vaccine.
We have zero.
Yeah, right.
So I guess you won't be able to work.
Yeah, I guess I'm not going to be there either. I'm going to take off the next year and a half. Something like that. Speaking of people who do crazy things, talk about this guy in Las Vegas. Did you hear about him? Mm. He was on an Alaska Airlines flight from Vegas to Portland over the weekend. Except he was riding on the airplane in a place you typically don't want to ride. On the wing.
Yeah, how'd he get up there?
Police have arrested a man who managed to climb the wing of a departing Alaska Airlines flight from McCarran International over the weekend.
Wow.
And yes, there's plenty of video of the stunt as well. But I don't think this was like a YouTuber. I think this guy has some mental challenges, so
Florida
to speak.
Man, meet Las Vegas man.
Yes. Flight 1367 from Vegas to Portland was taxiing out to take off when they saw a man climbing on board the wing. Sitting down on the wing and eventually taking off his shoes and socks.
Oh, he just wanted to get comfortable. He said, this is a nice seat.
He was on the wing for 45 minutes. Like, he was just laying down, hanging out, climbing on the wing tip, all sorts of crazy things.
I wonder what he thought.
And ultimately, though, he fell off. And that's kind of a far fall, honestly.
I'm trying to figure out how he got up there.
Here's him falling off. Hold on. I'll give you just a second of this, because I know you can't see it, but it was... Here he is. He's just laying down on the wing right now. See him? He's just chilling on the wing.
Can you imagine?
No shoes, no socks.
Being the guy in that window seat.
I mean, how pissed would you be, though, if indeed your plane was stopped?
45 minutes late.
But no, I'm fine because you have entertainment here. But if you're on the right side of the plane where you couldn't see what's going on, I'd be super pissed.
I'd be pissed regardless.
Well, I mean, this is pretty good entertainment, though.
Yeah, but screw the entertainment.
Well, it's one thing getting stopped because there's a line of planes about to take off. This is sheer entertainment right here, you must admit.
I mean, I guess.
Do you want to see him falling off?
Yeah, I want to see him falling off.
Hold on. Right now, he's laying on the wing playing dead. No, this is not like a four-seater. This is a 737 jet.
No shoes.
No shoes, no socks.
No socks.
They said he took the shoes and socks off to get a better grip on the wing.
No, he didn't.
Yeah, that's what they said. All right, hold on. Here's him about to fall off, I believe.
What, does he roll off?
Here. See, right now he is climbing on the wing tip. Can you see him?
Amazing. Where does he think he can go?
I don't know where he thinks he can go.
Well, wherever their destination
he's
is.
He's going to fall off.
I mean, those planes go, I mean.
Oh, shit.
Fast.
There you go.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. There he goes.
There he goes.
He did a full backflip, too, on his way down.
Okay. What an idiot.
My boy did a full backflip.
They can't figure out where he came from, but he was not inside of the plane at all. He was somehow running around on the tarmac
He ran up there.
They might want to look at their security around the airport there because
some of their security employees.
Yeah, good point.
That's a man that, he used to work there.
The flight was preparing for takeoff when the pilot noticed an individual running towards the aircraft.
Oh, Jesus.
Alejandro Carlson, 41, my age.
Of course, yeah, grown man.
He climbed up onto the wing somehow and stayed there for 45 minutes, took his shoes and socks off to get a better grip, and then he fell off. He fell off. So then the plane had to go all the way back to the gate for a full inspection, of course, too. So these people were delayed 2-3 hours
at least.
Make sure
he didn't have any friends with him because, that happens.
Oh, that was a pretty bad fall, though.
Yeah.
He's trying to climb up the wingtip. Where is he going? I don't know. Not Portland.
He wanted to go to Portland.
He's definitely not.
To be clear.
Actually, as soon as they even start getting ready for takeoff, he's probably going to be.
Oh, absolutely. No, I mean, they were moving, though.
The second
they hit
100 miles an hour, he would have been like.
Can
you imagine? He'd have flipped off and then got, road burned.
Yeah, I mean, I think that they take off or they start to pull up at, 140 knots or something like that. He's long gone at that point.
Absolutely. He would have made it in the sky. He wouldn't have made it in the sky. I don't know. But he's like, I need to get my toes involved because I need to get good grippage.
Exactly.
But, sir, you could have been naked, and you still would have flipped off.
Thinking he's Spider-Man. Yeah.
Paul checks in. What's up, Paul? How are you? They should have tased him. It would have taken, 15 minutes. He was going to fall off anyway.
Right.
I mean, Paul, I don't disagree with that.
Right, absolutely.
I mean, people were just sitting here for 45 minutes watching guy lay on the wing and then fall off. Lee checks in. Good morning, Lee. The loon could have gotten sucked into the engine. Yeah, of course.
Also that, yeah.
Have you ever gotten in your car and left a coffee mug on the roof or something? It doesn't take very long or a lot of speed to make the thing fly off.
Yeah, absolutely.
And these planes are going fast, obviously.
Fast.
You know?
Fast.
Karen said, this is like a Twilight episode coming to life. I totally agree. Sean said he bought a bunch of ammo today, actually. I was at Academy Sports getting my son Christmas gifts, and ammo was on sale.
Oh, that's nice. Wow.
Every other person that came in was buying ammo.
That's
I saw the price, went back in, and got my 500 rounds as well.
Good for you.
Good.
I'm about to go to Academy Sports, you said?
Academy Sports.
Oh, all right. Nice.
They did something good this weekend, I think, too.
Yeah.
Right? What did they do? Do you remember?
I think with OPD, they gave away 50 bikes.
50 bikes. Good job,
them.
Academy Sports. All right, so let's address this Cleveland Indians story from really last night, I think it broke. So, as you probably know, the Washington, formerly known as Redskins, are now the Washington football team.
Sorry.
I mean, you know, guys, you could have come up with something else. The Washington football team now.
What the hell have you been doing?
Well, the Cleveland Indians announced last night that they are officially going to drop the name Indians as well. I don't know if they're going to be the Cleveland baseball team or not. I don't know what they're going to change it to, but
I feel like we gave Washington all summer, and this is the best they could do.
I know nothing.
And you realize when they first put out the names they were going to choose, that was not even one of them.
No, that wasn't one of the options because people would have ferociously attacked them probably for that.
They said, let's give them options and then go in a whole different direction.
So the Cleveland baseball team. I guess. I don't know what they're going to call themselves. In July, the Washington football team, under pressure from sponsors like Nike and FedEx, ended the use of the word Redskins.
Oh, my gosh.
In 2019, the Indians removed logos of the mascot Chief Wahoo. Mm-hmm. So I don't think the move's a total surprise, but I don't know if anyone saw it coming this quickly. Also, there are some other teams out there that still are under attack. The Kansas City Chiefs, Atlanta Braves, Chicago Blackhawks. They've all said they have no plans to change their names.
He said, we're good.
I mean, are they really offending?
I don't know.
Well,
I guess
I mean,
that
you should know. You're
hey,
Indian.
Look, I have Native American in me, and I can tell you I'm not offended, but
is it less about, you know, I think it's like almost like the Eskimo pie. It's less about the name and more about like the figurehead that they choose for, like the actual mascot.
I don't know. I think it's probably the name, but they say that a lot of these Native American groups really are offended by this. So
yeah, Redskins.
If it's going to offend people, I guess take it away. It's just I can tell you I've got a little Native American in me, and it doesn't offend me.
Right, but
I don't
partake,
think I'm the right.
You don't partake in Native American culture.
I guess.
You guess.
It's not that you guess. You don't.
What is Native American culture? What would I be doing?
I don't know.
What is
Native American?
Have you ever been to a Chiefs game? You know that tomahawk chalk they do?
Yeah.
Yeah, that. Don't do that.
What about the Seminoles? Florida State Seminoles. Are they going to have to change their name as well?
No, they said they weren't because the Seminoles said that they gave them
permission cool
to do
it.
They're cool
with
it.
Yeah. So why are these Seminoles cool with it, but the Chiefs are not?
Because they got more money. The Seminoles said, bro, we just keep your money coming. We don't care.
Really? You think so?
You know, I don't know. I don't know what the other tribes, you know, what they have going on, but they
can you call a tribe meeting?
Yeah.
Can you get all
can you
the
hold
chiefs
a tribe
of the
meeting?
Clan?
More so with the Midwestern tribes because those are the ones that are pissed.
So what are the Braves? The Atlanta Braves. I mean, brave has a good connotation to it. If you're brave,
yeah, it's not really.
But what were the Braves? Any idea? What were the Braves known for?
Los Bravos. I don't know.
No clue. No, I have no clue.
Why do you change everything to the Spanish saying?
I know.
I just want to see if you can say it.
I'm offended.
Well, the Chiefs.
If you're offended, I'm sorry. I don't know.
The Chiefs, Braves, and Blackhawks say they are not going to change their names. I think at some point they still do, right? Don't you think they're going to? Don't you think they're going to come under pressure still?
Yeah.
And end up changing their name?
Yes.
I would think so.
I mean, maybe. I don't know.
I can't answer. I don't want to offend you, Justin. Right. I'm sorry.
If they changed their teams the Blackskins and they had like a, you know, some black guy.
Trust me, I'm very.
I would be upset.
If like, they were called the Blackskins.
Yeah, and they had like some, you know, this African American person just sitting in a chair and you'd be like, wait a minute.
I guess so.
What about a black bear?
They had a black bear, but their skin's not black, their fur is.
Big A checks in. What's up, Big A? How are you? This just hit. Oh, Big A has some breaking news for us. Here we go. This is from Big A, from our official virus correspondent, Big A. This just in, someone has turned into the Incredible Hulk from the vaccine.
So
thank you, Big A.
Funny.
So I will go get it now. So I'm going to get stronger. Will it make me taller by chance?
Will it make you taller?
Can I roll out of there at 6'2"?
Anything will make you taller, Justin.
Shut up. Don't get me excited like that.
Oh, God.
Indian skin is really brown. Red comes from paint, says Big A.
Oh, there you go. So it's kind of offensive because it's like, you know.
So it's not, okay.
You know?
Let me ask you a question here. This is the time of year where a lot of people are traveling. And
they should be, but probably not.
And anytime that I go on any sort of trip with my family, we pack up the car, and you cannot see out of the rear shield, the what do you call it?
The rear
view mirror. You can't see.
The back windshield.
Yeah, because the bags are stacked up in the back, so you cannot see in the rear view mirror at all. And my fear has always been that I would get pulled over, and they would say that that's illegal. You have to be able to see from the rear view mirror. Do you know the answer to that question? Is it illegal?
Is it illegal to not
is it
see?
Illegal to pack up your car so tightly where you can't see out of the rear view mirror?
I don't think so.
Lurch?
Yes and no.
Yes and no.
Because you got the side view mirrors, right? You got two of them.
You two have already seen this story, a-holes.
No.
I know exactly what's going on here.
I haven't seen it.
Yes, you must have.
I mean, Justin, it's a yes or no question. I mean, far be it for me to guess.
Every time.
50%.
They ask these kinds of questions. It's always
yes and no. Yes or no? Yes and no.
Right. Like, what do you
think? It depends.
You guys already saw. Like, what? It's not like a guess or number,
there's
Justin.
There's never an actual, yes, it's illegal. No, it's illegal.
Right. Trooper CB, like, skirting the line.
Let's go to our correspondent, Trooper Steve, from our.
I like being called that.
Oh yeah, from news anchor Steven Montiero.
Sorry, I said it in Spanish. I'm sorry. Sorry.
News anchor Steven Montiero. Let's see if it's illegal.
It's Central Florida. People are traveling. We're coming to and from. This happens. I'm just glad that I could probably see the license plate. So you're sitting in the car. You've got all these mirrors to look around your vehicle, but you can't see out the back window. So technically, yes, and technically, no, is the answer to this question. The catch to this is, if you cannot...
Trooper Steve, come on,
yes?
Man. Come on, yes or no? Don't yes and no.
My boy said technically yes and technically no.
Look out your rearview mirror and see anything from the rear of your car. You have to have your side view mirrors in place. Well, a lot of people are like, man, Trooper Steve.
So, you know, I know you cheated.
Every car has side view mirrors. No. You're right. But sometimes, you know, one's broken or not. But how the law reads is, if you can't see out the back window, you must have the side view mirrors in place. My suggestion is, just make sure you can see around your car.
Mm. If you have a... Huh. So yes and no, you were right.
Groundbreaking.
You were right. So it's not illegal then to pack the hell out of your car where you can't see.
Right, where's it gonna go? I mean, like.
But it is kind of dangerous. You think?
Yeah, I like being.
I like being able to see a little bit out of the rear view
mirror. I like being able to see only, and it's not for like my benefit. I mean, it's more so for the benefit of when I stop. Is the car behind me gonna stop? So I know where they're like, you know, tense up or not.
What about, let's say that you're a Washington football team fan, and you buy one of these, like, clear license plate covers. You know what I'm talking
the
about?
Clear ones?
Say it's a totally clear one, and it says Washington football team on the top. Are those legal?
Is there, like, a gloss that goes on top of your license plate?
Yeah, like this. Like, a clear license plate cover.
But it's got a little tin on it.
Well, okay, what if it's clear?
Okay, I had a clear one, and they told me to take it off because
why?
It shined on the, like they couldn't get a good picture of my license plate when going through the tolls.
Can I have a clear cover over my license plate, Trooper Steve?
I'm going to say yes.
Well, much. I don't know how else to say it. Can I have a clear cover over my license plate? And this is the stuff that I'm talking about, whether it's tinted, transparent. The answer is no. So when I was younger, my mom used to ask me, what don't you understand, the N or the O? And I used to stare at her like, huh? Look, the license plate, we don't own them. We're technically borrowing them from the state. And Florida law specifically talks about there should be nothing at all, no obstructions that visually impair your license plate, whether it's a clear one of these, tinted one, a half one, nothing is allowed on your Florida license plate.
If you have a question you want to ask Trooper Steve, go to clickorlando.com.
Thank you, Trooper Steve. Mm. Always checking in with us. Thank you, Shane Reeve. And by the way, you heard Bubba earlier, right?
Yes.
is he in trouble?
I'll be speaking.
All right, Shane Reeve, my boss just walked in. And, of course, I was supposed to leave it on the DL that Bubba was talking about his friend earlier. Mm. And leave it to Bubba.
The anatomy of the
All right, let's take a break. When we get back... So much to get to. Oh, Miami prison guard sneaks in cocaine for an inmate for $3,000. Too bad the inmate was undercover. Undercover police officer.
Oh,
didn't go well. Disney Plus subscribers. 86.8 million now. Far exceeding what they expected. Mm. But they are offering now some new streaming options. And talking about increasing the price. I'll tell you about that and plenty more. It's Justin Clark on the Florida Man Radio Network.
You're listening to You Have Power Radio with attorney Justin Clark.
Go to FloridaManAlarm.com right now for a free home security system from our good friends at Home Security Alarm Expert. $850 value, but you have to do it between now and the end of the year. You're going to love the system. They protect my family. I have an app where I can do anything that you need to do for your house. Lock the door, unlock the door, fix the thermostat, raise it, lower it. I can watch the front of my house, the back of my house, the inside of my house, all from this amazing app. Also, it monitors the house for carbon monoxide, fire, flood, smoke from anywhere in the world. I love it. But you have to go now to FloridaManAlarm.com to sign up for your free alarm system. And then the monitoring of it. Cost virtually nothing per month, less than a gym membership, a full lifetime warranty on all of the products, floridamanalarm.com, or call 844-517-0545.
Florida Man Radio. The Ed Till Show.
Yeah. I have to do 2 hours of shots of bourbon to wipe out like one bad wheat beer that somebody will sneak on. They're sneaking in on me. Give me a Budweiser. Give me a, I like Miller.
You're a PBR guy.
Well, my dad. My dad had all the good beers, and they were cheap. He had Ballantine's. He had Rheingold. He had Schlitz.
The Ed Till Show. Weekdays from noon till 3 on Florida Man Radio.
Join us in saluting the veterans of Central Florida. December's Veteran of the Month is 22-year United States Marine Corps veteran Jason Alderman of Sanford. We're hooking Jason up with a two-night stay at the Hard Rock Daytona Beach, $100 to Pittsoil, and more. Nominate the veteran in your life now to be our Veteran of the Month. Log on to floridamanradio.com now to get started. Florida Man Radio's Veteran of the Month. Thanks to TrueLeave.com.
A remarkable year like 2020 calls for a remarkable holiday offer from International Diamond Center. And here it is. 5 years, zero interest financing on any purchase for the entire month of December. Don't miss this extraordinary opportunity. Pick out that perfect gift and spread your payments over 5 years with zero interest and zero down. Everything's included. Come see the area's largest selection of pre-owned Rolex watches, GMT2 Batman and Pepsi models, two-tone Submariners, Yachtmasters, Sea Dwellers. IDC has nearly 500 pristine pre-owned Rolex watches in stock for gentlemen and ladies. All the popular models you can't find at authorized dealers right now. Imagine a stainless steel Rolex Yachtmaster for just $175 a month. Or a stainless and gold blue Submariner for less than $200 a month. Also, during the first 12 days of December, check out our website, shopidc.com, for secret buys and flash sales on the most popular holiday gifts. Items updated daily with limited time to act. Now through December 12th. Merry Christmas from International Diamond Center. All four Orlando locations. Credit details at shopidc.com.
Always get your go-to with the new $10 Tastemaker from Pizza Hut. A large pizza with up to three toppings for just $10. Choose contactless delivery or curbside pickup at pizzahut.com. Price higher in some locations. Limited time offer. Availability of contactless curbside delivery areas. Charges and minimums vary. Delivery charge not tip.
Stop paying high electric bills and upgrade the value of your home today with a solar power system from IQ Power Solar. It's never been easier. With no money down and financing options available, you'll be using the power of the sun to take back control of your power needs in no time. Get a free consultation and assessment of your home savings opportunities by calling IQ Power Solar today at 407-585-1018. Or to learn more, visit iqpowersolar.com.
Tune in weekly with Justin Clark during You Have Power for a new real estate segment, Real Sense, featuring Dawood Bedrosian from RE/MAX Town Center.
Hi, this is Dawood. I'll give you the facts on real estate trends as a buyer or seller, ways to find investments, what to look for when searching for a property or vacation home, flipping homes, owning versus renting, and how owning real estate is the cheat code to your success, plus a whole lot more.
Join us every Tuesday and brush up on all things real estate. Got a question? Call or text 321-339-1055 and get real-time responses. Real Sense, getting real on real estate. Date with Dawood.
Hey, it's Jeff Adams here. Let's face it, winters in Florida are hot. I mean, super hot, like 85 degrees hot. That's why you need a reliable AC unit in your house. Call Brian and his team at Four Seasons at 407-295-9231. 407-295-9231 or at 4acnow.com. 4acnow.com. Reach out to him today. Tell him Jeff Adams sent you. Four Seasons AC, the AC company you wish you called first.
Make the newly renovated Wet Spot in downtown Sanford your spot for ice-cold drinks and tasty food. Happy hour every day until 7 and the NFL package on Sundays. You won't want to miss a game. Get down to the Wet Spot in downtown Sanford.
Do you know how COVID-19 helped you out? It drove down home loan interest rates yet again. According to MarketWatch, you can expect to see rates drop even further this summer. You Have Realty has the experience, knowledge, and bilingual staff to assist you in navigating your home purchase during these times. You know what the best part is? It's free when we represent you as a buyer. Call us at 407-733-4700 and mention this ad to receive a free home warranty when you close on your home.
Bubba the Love Sponge.
Hey, it's Bubba the Love Sponge. Listen every weekday mornings right here on Florida Man Radio, powered by Anajar and Levine, accident attorneys. Call 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
Get your fix of Florida Man Radio anytime and anywhere you are. Of course, you can catch Florida Man on 660 AM and 105.5 FM. But now you can listen wherever you are with the all-new Florida Man Radio app. And don't miss a second of the conversation at home by listening on your Alexa device. Just say, Alexa, play 105.5 Florida Man Radio. Florida Man is everywhere, unfiltered, unafraid. Get it how you need to, now.
Now, back to You Have Power Radio with attorney Justin Clark.
Happy National Vaccine Day. Everyone's all excited. Governor Cuomo's excited up in New York. The first person to get a vaccine today was up at the Long Island Jewish Medical Center in Queens. She did it during a press conference that Governor Cuomo was having. She was at the hospital getting the needle.
Yeah.
But Cuomo was having a press conference. They kind of did like a joint press conference thing. Mm-hmm. You want to hear a little bit of this? Here's what Cuomo had to say. Hold on.
So, Sandra, you didn't flinch. I take it that Dr. Chester has a good touch.
She has a good touch, and it didn't feel any different from taking any other vaccine.
I mean, how many vaccines does a lady take? That doesn't feel any different than any other vaccine. What, she take 10, 12 a year?
I mean, working at a hospital?
What all vaccines do you need to take? Isn't there just one yearly vaccine? It's the flu shot, basically?
Yeah, but
what else do you take?
Has to do, like, the TB, the rubella, the measles.
Yeah, you only do that once in your lifetime or something?
I think it's, like, once every 3 years.
Every 3 years?
Once every 2 years.
Oh,
yeah.
I'm probably way due on a bunch of vaccines then.
So she's probably, yeah.
When's the last vaccine you've gotten, Lurch? Like decades, right?
A long time ago.
So
I did get the flu shot, but that was like 6 years ago, 7 years ago.
Yeah.
I didn't know I was due for all these vaccines. I mean, no one, I should get an email or something, shouldn't I?
Right.
How am I going to know?
Notification. Yeah.
The hell do I know I'm owed some vaccines?
You're supposed to keep up with them, I guess.
Yeah, right.
What the hell,
so
right?
You do if you did want to go get the vaccine,
yeah.
And they're like, you also have to get this,
nah.
This, and this.
Nah, we'll split it up.
I'll be back next week, and we'll.
Yeah. I promise I'll be back.
And I'll never see him again.
And this is all free, right? They're not charging anyone for any of these vaccines. I mean, isn't the government paying for it all? I don't think you have to pay for it.
We're asking. I don't know.
Do you have to pay for any of the? You don't have to pay to get a test, right? If you go wait in line at the convention center or whatever,
no,
that's all free, isn't it?
Yeah, that's true.
I mean, I'm thinking the vaccine's going to be free.
But most people got to pay for a flu shot.
I think everyone has to pay for a flu shot, don't they? I don't know.
I can't remember.
Great.
Dr. Chester, it all worked. The kid from your end.
Everything worked perfectly. Thank you.
And you're feeling well.
Governor,
she just got the shot, Governor.
Right. How do you feel?
I feel like I just got a needle in my arm, first of all, but the side effects haven't kicked in yet.
Right. She passes out dead.
In fact, I feel great at the moment, except for my arm hurts because you just put a needle in it.
Right.
But certainly the side effects haven't kicked in yet.
I would have pretended to die.
Right
there. Well, Governor, I feel.
Pass out.
He'll be like, oh.
Just kidding, Gov.
Cut the cap joking, buddy.
Feeling well. I would like to thank all the frontline workers, all my colleagues who've been doing a yeoman's job to fight this pandemic all over the world. I am hopeful. I feel hopeful today.
I wonder, did they have a lottery or something there? How do you think they chose her? I mean, is her last name start with an A? I mean, I don't know how they decide who's going to go first.
They were, look, in this is not me. This is literally the news that I'm just like basing off the media.
Yeah.
The media has been saying for weeks now, and they've been priming us that, oh, African Americans and other minority groups are not wanting to take the vaccine. So you know the poster child for taking the vaccine. Mm. They had to be a minority. They had to.
Native Americans too?
No.
I mean, this I mean, not him.
Now we have a second New York health worker has gotten the virus
so
vaccine.
Keep updating that as like every
I guess.
Three, four, five, three, six, seven,
four,
eight.
Ten.
Until we hit 10 million people, we're going to update every single one of them. Oh, and the third person has gotten the vaccine.
Fox News has nothing better to do.
I'm relieved. I feel like healing is coming. I hope this marks the beginning to the end of a very painful time in our history. I want to instill public confidence that the vaccine is safe. We're in a pandemic, and so we all need to do our parts to put an end to the pandemic and to not give up so soon. There's light at the end of the tunnel, but we still need to continue to wear our masks.
Did she write this herself, you think, or did they did this for her?
Oh, you know they gave her some talking points.
To social distance. I believe in science. As a nurse, my practice is guided by science, and so I trust science. What I don't trust is that if I contract...
We want you to say whatever's on your mind, but we have a little something written down for you just in case.
Like, and look, here it is. Her mask is on. Yeah. That might not even be her talking. Just say watermelon under your mask 10 times, yeah. And we're just going to, you know, they're going to have some lady in the background, like, actually saying the words. Like, they were like, just yawn a few times, and we'll make it seem like you're talking.
Track COVID, I don't know how it will impact me or those who I come in contact with.
Are they going to make us get spayed and neutered next as well, like we do to our animals?
So I encourage everyone to take the vaccine.
So there you have it. The first person in the United States has been... injected with the virus vaccine.
So I was watching this show. I was telling you guys about it.
Yeah.
It's called, what's the name of it? Utopia. So basically, like, they cause this virus, and in the vaccine of the virus, they, like, sterilize people for, like, two generations or something like that.
Really?
And they did that because, like, they were like, oh, the Earth is too crowded, and we got to slow up production, basically. So they basically sterilized everybody. For the next two generations, and so that way we can start having our resources back on the earth. So
well, let me have two first, and then you can sterilize me.
Well, basically, they created a virus that targeted children, and it had a 100% death rate, which means when the vaccine came out, 100% of parents wanted their kids to have it, but that was the generation that they were sterilizing. So the kids, your kids wouldn't be able to have kids. You know?
Let's say your text messages. Kenneth is here. What's up, Kenneth? How are you? Atlanta Braves had Chief Nokohama. Who is actually a Cherokee Indian. Thank you. Oh, Lee said that just like a dog, I've had all my shots, got my paperwork, bud, so I'm good to go. Okay, good. I thought I heard that some of them expired after like 15 years or something, you had to go back, but there's no way. I don't remember when. I'm sorry.
Seventh grade.
I remember MMR, like measles, mumps, rebellion, or something like that. I remember that one.
Measles, mumps, rebellion.
And I think they might have said you got to go back in like 15 years to take another one. But
TB shot, all that.
If I don't get an email reminder about it, I mean, how am I going to remember?
How am I going to know?
Yeah, exactly. What I don't have a calendar for 15 years from now to remind me.
When did people first start using emails?
I don't know. A long time ago. Speaking of dogs, though, some dogs, they say now, can be trained to detect the virus from your sweat. Dozens of trials have had success rates between 76 and 100%. Now, this would be cool.
So what kind of training did you undergo for this?
Whoa.
Are you calling me a dog?
Whoa.
Just because I sleep in the dog house. Doesn't mean that I'm a dog. Detection dogs, like those that sniff out drugs or explosives at airports, are taught to sniff for certain infections and diseases. Some countries are exploring the possibility of using those types of dogs as a rapid and reliable and cheap way to pre-screen people for the virus. I mean, this would be pretty good, right? I mean, if a dog could just walk around and smell 1,000 people and figure out who has it or not. This is good, right?
Yeah.
You don't have to get the nasal swab thing. I don't like people taking a Q-tip and putting it near my brain. Do you?
Yeah.
Have you had that done to you yet?
The brain one?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The jab in your nose? Sucks. It does kind of suck, doesn't it? This might hurt a little bit.
Yep.
Yeah, right. Yeah, exactly. I'm like, lady, take it easy on me. I mean, how much swab do you really need up there? Oof. And why do you have to? Why do they have to dig the Q-tip so deep into your brain? You would think they could just do a little bit.
Yeah. Who knows?
I would much rather a dog tell me if I have it or not. Dog just, you know, you can even lick me if you want. I would rather a dog come give me a little lick on my leg than you putting the Q-tip in my brain.
Yeah.
Well, in this new study based in France and Lebanon, researchers took sweat samples from 177 patients at hospitals. 95 were positive for the virus and 82 were negative. Six dogs had their sniffing abilities put to the test and performed dozens of trials with a success rate of 76 to 100%.
Wow.
And that's pretty good, I think.
Yeah.
Unless you're a false positive trying to get on the plane and you have to cancel your trip at that point. That kind of stinks.
Shoes and socks off.
The dog was like, oops.
For the grip. Yeah. Gotta get the grip. It's all about the grip.
Experts say it's a promising first step, but added that more work is needed. I guess so. Mm. I mean, I always find it fascinating that dogs can really sniff for a disease, right?
Yeah.
I mean, how could that really be possible? It must be somewhat possible, but I still don't understand it. Or even explosives. It's always been weird to me they could smell explosives.
Yeah.
Drugs, maybe you understand a little bit better because drugs kind of do, like weed.
Yeah.
I could be a weed dog. I mean, I can smell weed in a car. That's not that hard. Hey, they have weed in there. Sounds like they smoked recently. Smells like they smoked recently.
They have weed.
But
you have weed. Radio.
All right.
Does this mean you're going to get another dog?
No, I have enough dogs in my house, bud.
So what if you come home and there's a fourth one?
Then I'm going to put my foot down and say, send it back. And then they won't send it back and I'll just deal with it. But don't you think three dogs is sufficient?
Oh, yeah.
I know. I think that's more than enough.
Three dogs is too much as is.
I think two is.
Right. Three dogs is definitely more than enough.
And it's like my dog and Pilar's mom's dog have like bark offs every time someone comes over. Mm. They won't stop barking. I think two dogs is plenty. I don't think we even needed a third, honestly.
Nope.
But the third one doesn't bark, so that's good. No. But the third one eats the couch. So, and like shoes and things.
I thought your two-year-old was the one eating the shoes.
No. It was definitely the dog. My two-year-old does not eat shoes.
I see.
That would be a little odd, wouldn't it?
Just a bit.
That would be very strange, I would say.
I wouldn't judge you, but, you know.
Why is your two-year-old eating sneakers?
Right. We would look at her weird.
But I think that three dogs and two cats is a sufficient amount of animals.
Three dogs, two cats,
and
two
a horse,
kids,
and two horse. Kids.
And the horse doesn't live there.
But I mean, the horse doesn't live there, but it's still an animal that you got to deal with.
Right.
So you got to take care of.
That's a lot.
I mean, trust me, the horse costs way more than the rest of them combined.
So you're a zookeeper.
What do you think? Yeah. What do you think dog food for? What does like one dog cost per month, you think? To have a dog in your house, you know, with the dog food or vet bills or whatever.
That's a Lurch question.
What, $100 a month, something like that? Not even? How much is dog food?
We buy, I think it's $34, it's like $35.
And for your dog food bag?
Yeah, well, for Snow and Faith, but they're like smaller dogs. And I think for Achilles.
But how long does that last? A week? 2 weeks? A month?
No, it lasts a good while. I'd probably say a month, yeah.
So $35 a month for two dogs. That's not that big of a deal. But they're tiny.
Yeah.
They're small dogs.
I mean, Snow's like a small to medium-sized dog. Mm. Faith is a tiny dog. And then Achilles, he's a medium to large dog. I think my mom, she doesn't spend a lot of money, but, I mean, it's a significant amount of dog food. So it can get up there, but what are you going to do?
I think probably the average person probably spends like $80 a month on a dog.
What do you spend?
Really?
I have no idea.
That's
but. I don't know. I see them dragging in dog food all the time.
Yeah.
So it's probably a significant amount for three dogs and two cats.
That's also if you,
and kitty litter, too.
Yeah, if you buy wet food and dry food.
Yeah.
And then treats. And then.
The cat was pretty expensive for me. So, you know, shots and food and litter. Yeah. Always changing the litter.
And then your food.
And then my food. Seven more shows to go this year, guys. That's it. And 2020 is over.
That's exciting.
Can you believe that?
I know.
All right, good job for Monday, Brianna. How do I find out more about you, please?
That is Brianna Daniel Official. All social media except for Parler. It is 12 Black Dresses.
Lurch.
Lurch FMR on Twitter, Nando the Ferno on Instagram, or petco.com.
Thank you. Thank you for joining us on a Monday. I love you. I really do. Please do me a favor, though, and stick around because Bill O'Reilly is coming up next, followed by our in-house legend, Edward Till. From noon until 3, when Shando and his boys Yofre and DJ, the anchor tenant, takes over from 3 to 7, followed by Real Talk with G-Love and Kenny from 7 until 8. The party starts again tomorrow morning with my good buddy Bubba the Love Sponge at 6 a.m. Brianna, I don't know much, but I do know one little teeny tiny thing.
What's that?
I'll see you right back here again tomorrow morning, 10 a.m. on the Florida Man Radio Network.